Yeah. Sarah, can you just move along? Can you just move along, please?
Thank you.
We begin in 5 minutes. We begin in 5 minutes.
Everybody's finished. You know what? Can you hear? Excuse me. Hurry, hurry, take it fast. I'm gonna catch a four on you. Oh, no, I'm catching that. Yeah. Teal.
All the days have passed away in your wrath. We finish our years like a sigh. The days of our lives are 70 years. And if by reason of strength there be 80 years, yet their boast is only labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off.
In the rock, in the rock, I lie. In the shadows, I will lie. When the dawn of night, all raging over me.
Somebody with The name of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, you may be seated for a minute. I am Reverend Kerry Dunkley, and I will be your moderator today. I want to greet the platform party, members of the Berry family. Brothers and sisters, I greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus. We have gathered here today, and I'm quite certain that this is not easy for any of us. But the Bible states, in the midst of life, we are in death. It pleases the Lord to call home Wayne Anthony Nash, who was born in the year 1980 on December 6th, November 6th. It pleases the Lord to call him home on the 30th of November 2019. Death is something that you and I will never get used to. But I want to say to the church that we have a lively hope that one day we will see our brother again. He is not dead, he's sleeping. And on the resurrection morning, Wayne will stand before the judgment seat of God to give an account of all the deeds that he has done. I ask you once again to stand and turn to your program. And our first hymn, as I travel through this pilgrim land, there's a friend who goes with me, leads me safely to the sinking sand. It's the Christ of Calvary. Brothers and sisters, once again, please stand.
As I journey through this pilgrim land,
Somebody shout hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, at this time, Evangelist Dennis Spirit will come with the opening prayer. And immediately after the prayer, we are inviting Natasha, Nasha Haley Nash, daughter, and Renisha Nash, sister, to come. And they will be doing the first lesson. And that will come to us from Revelation 21, verse 1 to 7, immediately after the prayer. Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father and our most righteous God, as we gather in this place today on a very sad occasion, oh God, where we mourn the loss of a loved one. Today, I pray, God, for those who mourn of the loss of a son, a brother, an uncle, or even just a friend, divine God. There are pain in the heart and pain in many souls, God. And many weep uncontrollably, divine God, because they thought that today might be the last day that they will see this young man. But, oh God, my mind goes back to the scripture that said Lazarus was sick. Hallelujah. And the Bible teaches, divine God, that you tarried for days before you went to the family mansion. And by the time you get there, hallelujah, the Bible says that Lazarus was already buried and in the grave. But because of the mission, God, that you are on, divine God, the death and the sister said by now he might be stinketh. And oh God, the situation that lies around the death did not perturb you. Did not bother you any at all, divine Father, because the mission that you are on is that one day Lazarus will live again, divine God. And so today I pray, God, that even though we mourn, and even though, divine God, we weep uncontrollably, and even though we cannot stand, divine God, because we are weak in our knees, divine God, and many of us have turned away our heads, divine Father, because of the situation. But I pray, God, that you comfort some hearts, and comfort some minds, and comfort some souls today, divine God. And oh God, I pray, divine Father, that in comforting souls and minds and hearts today, divine God, that you will whisper in some people's ears, divine God, that today shall not be the last day upon viewing this young man. But one day, divine Father, in the resurrection, divine God, then again that he shall resurrect, divine God, and stand before you. And the Bible teaches that he shall give account for every deed that he has committed. And so today, divine God, I pray that you bless the hearts of your people. I pray, divine God, that you touch the mind and hands and body of those who are sick, divine Father. And oh God, those who cannot keep up because of the tremendous pressure that lies in this room today, divine God, I pray, Almighty God, that you are the great physician and that you shall touch them. Strengthen them and bless them in every aspect, oh God, of this program. Those that is already gone and the rest that is to come. I pray that your mighty hands shall rest, remain, and abide with us all. In Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen.
Good morning. Good afternoon, everyone. This Bible scripture reading is taken from Revelation 21, verses 1 to 7. Now I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. Also, there was no more sea. Then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice coming from heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. And he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Then he who sat on the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Here ended the portions of God's holy word. We honor by saying, thanks be to God.
Thank you very much, Nashahe. Nashahe Lee and Renisha. Nashahe Lee is the daughter of the deceased. And I want to say to my brothers, know that Nashahe Lee is fatherless. For those of us who are privileged to be around her, let us be a father figure. Because I'm sure in the spirit, her father will be pleased. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
At this time, we'll have the cottage police station, and they will be coming to us at this time.
I've lost a good friend along life's way. A loved one departed in heaven to stay. But thank God I didn't lose everything. Said they cared. In time of my trials, they were never there. But in my disappointment, in my season of pain, one thing never wavered, one thing never changed.
please. Brothers and sisters, as I was sitting there and I was thinking, in this very country that we are living in, I realize that whenever one becomes successful, it attracts attacks. Hallelujah. I'm going to say it again. Success in our country now attracts attack, because some people don't want you to go forward. So they will try anything, Lord Jesus Christ, to stop you on the journey. But I want to say, we are politicians on this platform today. Too many people are getting away with these kinds of murders. And we just go to prison, spend 3 years, and we come back out, and we kill again. This young man was a promising figure, Lord Jesus Christ. Nobody no more become successful again, because people are going to them. But I plead the blood of God's Son Jesus Christ. Oh, somebody talk to me here. Somebody talk to me here. Somebody talk to me here. But today we must love the murderers, because Jesus said in Romans 12, he said, vengeance is mine, I will repay. And I close with this. Politicians, hanging must resume. I know you not say amen. Because if you kill me, somebody will kill you. You stay there, look on me, look. You go on, look. If you kill me, somebody will kill you. We are not birds. Somebody talk to me here. Have you been here struggling? Send them to school. Jesus Christ, and when them come out to some, you must be crazy. You must be crazy. And we just sit down and it's a bury them, and it's a bury them, and it's a bury them. The devil is a liar. I'm finished. We're done. Hallelujah. Oh, somebody give me praise in the house. Promising young man. I'm 6 years older than him. Promising young man. And somebody just kill him. And we just cry and we just sit down. They better fast and pray. And ask Master God to intervene. We finish. Yeah, we done. Somebody shout hallelujah here. Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody give him a praise. Somebody who employed people. I put bread on others' table. Taking care of other people's family. Can you imagine? And we just bury them. You must be joking. You must be joking. You just bury them. We finish. We're done. But as I said, the second lesson comes to us from St. John. Yes, we say it already. We say it already. We say when they kill you, somebody must kill them. I could have gone 50 color 1 minute. I could have gone 100 color. Yes. Somebody said, But the second lesson comes to us from St. John chapter 14, 1 to 3. Lydia Hay, sister. But comes with that lesson.
Good afternoon, everyone. The scripture reading is taken from John 14, 1 to 3. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
Here in the readings of God's holy word. Thank you.
Put your hands together for them, please. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please be seated. At this time, the Mile Valley High School will now come to us with your children.
Everyone, I must first apologize for our principal who will be late. The Mile Valley High School family stands in support and solidarity today on this very sad occasion and offers our heartfelt condolences for the loss of your spouse, father, brother, uncle, cousins, relatives, and friend, Wayne Nash. It is truly an understatement to say that the past few weeks have been extremely difficult for you. Our words are inadequate to express our sympathies and bring comfort to you in this time of extraordinary sadness. We dare not to say that we understand, because we all experience and process grief in different ways. But we want you to know that the members of the Mile Valley family have been praying almost without ceasing for your strength and comfort as you go through this season of grief. From time to time in life, we experience life-altering moments that confront us with a profound choice, either pushing us away from God or moving us closer to Him. May this movement prove the latter for you. Today we want to remind you that in spite of your loss, in spite of your heartache, in spite of your pain, and even in spite of your doubts and questionings, God knows exactly what we need and when we need it. We can be assured that our God knows us intimately. He is acquainted with the feelings of our infirmities. He is the friend who sticks closer than a brother, and He gives us space to mourn and time to heal. Demario, Jordan, Akilia, and the other children, your father was one of a kind. He was there for every registration, every report days, even at the football matches, he was there. He was there our last parent day. He was also one of our sponsors at the Mile Valley High School pageant, a true supporter of the Mile Valley High School family. So, Natalie, Demario, Jordan, Akilah, our prayers for you today is that you feel the love and comfort of God during this time of loss. Members of the family all, we are asking that God will fill your hearts and minds with hope and with His peace that surpasses all understanding. The Bible expresses it well. Pray about everything. Tell God your needs. If you do this, you will experience God's peace, which is far more wonderful than the human mind can understand. His peace will keep your thoughts and your hearts quiet and at rest as you trust in Christ Jesus. We continue to pray for your strength as you hold on to the unchanging arm of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Sleep on, Wayne, and take your rest.
Thank you very much, Mile Valley. Mile Valley High School. Brothers and sisters, we are now at the tribute, Sergeant Gordon. And immediately after Sergeant Gordon, we will have the Independent Funeral Directors Association, Western Chapter. So we have these two tributes.
And all the time? Right, I'm Kwame Gordon, the sergeant in charge of the Cottage Police Station. Right, so feel free to give us any information in relation to the murder here to help us clear the murder, all right? 440-3943, that's my personal number, and the station number, 553-4419, right? Please help us. One verse, quick, sir. Reggae version. Write this down. Mm.
Nash was a member of the Western chapter, and that is why we're here today, to support the family, to support the friends and well-wishers, and offer our sincere condolences to you, and to say a few words, of course. This is it. The family of the Independent Funeral Directors Association Limited stand with the Nash family in this time of bereavement. The Apostle Paul in his letter to the Romans wrote, "Rejoice with those who rejoice, mourn with those who mourn. Therefore, on this day, we share your grief and we extend our sincere condolences to the family, to the friends, to the loved ones and the well-wishers. In time of death, it is hardly ever easy to console grieving families, friends and loved ones. It is never easy to grapple with the pain of losing a loved one. In fact, death, as well as we know, leaves a void that can never be filled. The difficulty in accepting that a loved one has passed is sometimes a never-ending task. It often brings the familiar question, how, where, when, and of course, why? Why did Nash leave us? Why didn't you leave us so soon? However, despite the hesitation in coming to terms with the passing of the late Wayne Nash, I want to challenge everyone here today to keep his memories alive. I challenge his children to keep his legacy of being a good father. I challenge his friends and families to keep every smile, every joyful moment, every tear and every laughter. I promise you all to keep them alive. Renowned writer Mitch Albom penned it best when he wrote, "Death ends a life, not a relationship." The relationship you shared with Wayne Nash, of course, echoes through eternity each time you speak of him, and continue his legacy in every way you can. Allow his smile to brighten your hearts and practice every good thing he ever thought. Finally, today, as we say goodbye to Nash, I agree it is hard. So cry if you must, grieve if you will, but when you are through, remember the words of Alan Alexander. Promise me you'll never forget me, because if I thought you would, I'd never leave. Keep his memories alive, Wayne Nash. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Independent Funeral Directors, Western Chapter. Put your hands together again for them, everybody. Coming to us at this time is a member of Parliament for Northwest Manchester. And before Mr. Shaw comes, you notice we have two members of Parliament here, and they are not of the same party. It speaks volume how Wayne lived his life. Am I speaking truth? It speaks volume. We have one from the opposition, and we have one from the governing party. Perhaps Wayne used to think like how I'm thinking. I am not PNP nor JLP. I vote for any party who governs the country in the people's interest. So if I vote for one party this term and that party don't do well, then we are going to switch. But I say, look, we have two members of parliament. It tells us that this young man was not a biased soul. At this time, I want you to put your hands together and welcome a well-known man in this parish, Mr. Hartley Shaw, as he comes. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Pastor Dunkley, Reverend Terry Ann Smith, and our other ministers on the platform, my good friend, colleague member of parliament, Nikhil Felix, our councillor of the Mayor Gully Division, and deputy mayor of Mandeville, Mr. Omar Fritz, the caretaker for the Jamaica Labour Party in Northwest Manchester, members of the bereaved family, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. This is a very sad occasion. Forces on all of us a moment of reflection. Because there's one thing I can tell you, we cannot continue like this. We cannot continue like this. And one of the problems that we face today is what I refer to as a crisis of falling standards. Because oftentimes many of us see things that are wrong. We see behavior that is inappropriate. We hear things that are said coming out of the mouths of many people, including young people, and we know that they are wrong. And one of the things that too many of us are guilty of is accepting inappropriate behavior as something that is normal. We have to turn it around, you hear me? And this can't be done by the government, the opposition, and the police alone. It can't be done by states of emergency and zones of special operation. We need a zone of special operation in the minds and hearts of every Jamaican. That's where we need a zone of special operation. And we're either going to have to, there is more good than there is evil in this country. And if we stand up together for good, we will overcome. And wherever we see the wrong, we must call it out. If you see wrong in the society, among our young people, or anybody, call it out. If you see wrong in the police force, call it out. If you see wrong in the political directorate, call it out. But because we are all citizens of Jamaica, and we need to rebuild our country. The book of Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 12, check it out. It says, they that are of thee shall build the old waste places, raise up the foundations of many generations, be repairers of the breach and restorers of paths to dwell in. You hear that? Repair the breach. The breach of love, the breach of respect for human life. Repairers of the breach, they shall call us. Restorers of the homestead we call Jamaica. So as I come down, this young man was an example in the community of productivity, decency, proud of his children, took care of all of them, hard working. We give God thanks for his life. And I want to sing the Lord's Prayer for him and his family. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
Mr. Shaw, well said.
You are speaking my language. It is sad. Isn't it sad, brothers and sisters? We are sick as a minister of the gospel. I'm tired of attending funeral services of this nature. I am tired. And I'm speaking the truth. I am tired. It's time the church rise up and let God arise and the enemies be scattered. Nicholas Simmons is a cousin of the deceased at this time. Put your hands together and welcome Nicholas as he comes.
Good morning. A tribute to our real one. An exact example of being responsible, considerate, a spectacular father, and how to be a man. Wayne Nash was a trendsetter, a man whom us as young men of the current generation aspire to emulate his maturity, attitude towards getting work done, and showing the most loving and peaceful personality traits. As a child, he would often stop by Nick's Minimart and ask the owner, which is my mother, how are things? And her reply would most times be, Nick nasty and I shop. He'd then turn to me and say, Nick, you're smarter than that. And that alone would tell me to pull up my socks. But understanding that I was just a young free soul, he would give a short, stern lecture on the importance of being a man of success and the protection of precious assets. And turn to my mother and say, no worry, I'll make you proud. From bars, transport routes, to the iconic Nash and Sons funeral services, he was productive in all his business endeavors. Even if it seemed impossible, the manner he applied was a simple, intricate technique some would otherwise class as miserable. But we all understood that his techniques were proven to be highly effective and worked like a charm. His elegance and simplicity captured the hearts of a record amount of people, cementing a legacy of kindness, loyalty, and gratitude to anyone who bears or possesses any relation to the Nash name. Until we see you again, in Nash, we love you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Simmons.
Thank you very much.
Michael Phillips is the Member of Parliament for Northwest Manchester. He will be coming to us at this time. And immediately after Mr. Phillips, we will have the Councillor of Mile Gully Division, also the Deputy Mayor of Mandeville, Rohan Kennedy. Brothers and sisters, put your hands together and welcome MP Phillips as he comes.
Appreciating ministers, to our praise team, to my colleague, Member of Parliament, Audrey Shaw, Deputy Mayor Ron Kennedy, and Councillor, and as Mr. Shaw said, my opponent, Mr. Omar Fritt, to the bereaved family, my brothers and sisters in Christ, and I think there's another Councillor, I'm sure I saw outside, Councillor Mario Mitchell, who is right here in the corner. You know, we usually say that we're coming here to celebrate the life of a loved one. And when coming here today, you know, as speakers, you try and play over in your mind what it is that you're going to say. But as I sit here, I actually have a bit of bitterness in my heart. Because when I think back of the 10 years that I have known Wayne, known the human being that he has been, knowing the contribution he made to the community, the wider community, from back to school. Those of you who know him, every time he travels, he brings back barrels of books and pencils, drive around himself, And when Reverend talk about Self and MP Shaw being here, I don't know if Nash ever voted for me. No, I don't know who he voted for. I don't know if it was PNP or GLP, but I know him to be a good human being. And because of that, I never yet have to ask him if he ever vote for me, or ask him for vote for me. Whenever he sees my vehicle at the office, he will stop. And those of you know where he lives, you know he's been cutting the road going out there. So if you can give him a few bags of cement, he would take it. But if you don't have it, it's all right. It won't do him work. But as I was just saying to Brother Pierre, I remember my first interaction with him. I think it was 2010. When the police, unfortunately, Serge, you weren't there. But the police prosecuted a few taxmen in Milebury. And if you know Milebury, there's no route between Milebury and Ballymore. So when the taxman them bring down passengers and them have load, them have to carry them to Ballymore. But this day the police decides that they're going to prosecute everybody who come off of that route. And Nash was one of them. And if you know him, he have a temper to him. And I remember I was present there with them. And I decided I was going Black Road with them too. I agreed with them in what that the police was being hard and high-handed. And I remember when the soup invited us to Mandeville. And I went with them. And I sat beside Nash in that meeting. And his temper was getting the better of him then. And I remember him said to me, him said, "Boss, this is the last day I'm ever driving taxi. And now this me want to end up in jail and can't provide for my family." That's a serious thing. And he never turned back. To show the character of the man, if I was helping a family with the disease, and they paid him in full, he would pick up the phone and say, "MP, don't bother go through with your part. God, them pay me already, them are gonna take the money for themselves." That is the type of person we're talking about. An honest person. Yeah? I could close my eyes and know, and leave it up to him and know that he would be honest in what he would be doing. But the other day I was making a presentation in Parliament, and just to show you where our society is going, oddly. Between 2014 and 2019, the beginning of 2000 or the end of 2018, we have only had 2 murders in the Milebury police area. 2. And the 2 of them are by cutlass, domestic violence. In 2019 alone, we had 4 shootings. 2 of them murder. Wayne is one of them. 1 injury. And we have had more than 5 hold up by the gun in an area that we only had 2 murders in 4 years. And what is hurting is that many from the wider communities harboring some of them criminals there. Yes. Now, see something. That the type of policing that when some people call me and say, "Why the police dump on them hard?" But the type of policing that we used to in Milebury have changed. That's some hard criminals in the area. And when them go, look at the shops them in Milebury Square. Well, I mean, them breaking them morning, day and night. And when them bring the liquor from a yard, same yard them in the Milebury area. When you sit down and drink it instead of report it to the police. And that's why me believe, sir. As much as God said we are to forgive and forget, you can't forget that one. I'm not forgive that one. Because tomorrow it might just be me or one of you. And as I always say, crime don't have no color, you know. And the days gone by, I don't say politician, I don't want them to perpetrate crime. No, the criminal have more money than we, and they will perpetrate it. But I want to know, just keep the faith. But we, not only me and Adley, and those of us who sit down up here, the pastors or the police can deal with this. But it's one warning I have to tell them. Is that anyone at our residence in Northwest Manchester, I feel like them bigger than the law. When the police come knocking, you can call me because me send them if me know that you are a criminal. And I'm not just saying that. Because I came to Northwest Manchester to leave it a better place when I leave than I found it. And in all the years that I've been here in Northwest, I've not seen the cold and callousness against each other that I've seen. And it's not how I want to see the place. And I'm sure that's not how you want it. Because I know many of you didn't wake up this morning and give God thanks for the gift of life. Eh? I won't even ask you to put up on your hand who do it. Because a lot of us wake up this morning and think that life is ours. Not realizing that God gave us the gift of love, the gift of understanding, the gift of life. It is not for one of us to take it, but it is only God's duty, and death is a must. But it is not for me and you to determine that. So I beg of you, when we leave here, the brother said, it is sad of what happened to him. But let us leave here and try and make a difference, that it won't be another member of our family or a friend that we know. And Mr. Sharma, I beg you, when you go to cabinet meeting tomorrow, beg them for a police care for my gun police station. Please. Yeah. Thank you. Because the car that they have right now is a loaner from Kendal. And Kendal already shot a police car. Yeah? So I beg you, since we said we're working together to deal with this issue of crime, carry that message from here. To the family, as with Job, when everything was taken from him, he kept his faith. Keep your faith. Believe me, people here is not because I'm here saying Nash was a popular person. It's because he had touched nearly every single person here while they are here with you today. Nash was more than just a constraint to me. He was a friend. I can say that I can call him a friend. And we're hurting with you. But keep the faith. Because for sure, I know his soul is resting in peace.
Good afternoon, everyone. Oh, MP's my boss, and we were allotted 3 minutes. He borrowed 2 of mine, so I only have 1 minute left. As the boss, I have to comply. You know, Wayne was an humble person, hardworking, ambitious, one who believed highly in community development. He was always there in the school, in the churches, in every social event within the community. And MP mentioned that he don't know if he voted for him, and he didn't ask. Well, I asked him, and he said, based on how I was performing, he didn't do it the last time, but this time, he was going to do it. You know, we have partnered in a lot of social events, you know. And when I say he was humbly, he was really humble because we have done a lot of outreach, work on a lot of projects together without any fanfare. And the young people, young persons that are here can take something, a lot of us, all of us can take something from his life and the way he lived it. He wasn't the one who sit on the corner and said, boy, not now, go on. He made something go on. You know, and that was a fine example for all of us. Everything he touched, it may be unorthodox, it may be not scientific, but it was successful. And I want to salute the man for that. And all of us here today, as we mourn, we can take comfort in that. His children, in particular, when things like these happened, you know, he left your children behind and other family. I know it's much be harder than them. But if we want to really honor the man and don't let this one pass like the wind of yesterday, as the sergeant said, he left his number. We could try and solve this one. Many of us here today know what happened. And I just want to ask you, beg you, the best tribute you can ever give to the man is make we help solve this one. Pass on the information to the relevant authority. Whenever we have the safety meeting with the police, I think we have about 12 last year's that, he was always there. Quite a few in Milebury Square moderated them. He was the man with the roving mic asking questions. You know, and if he's not there, if he were not there, he would send along his sound system. So he was very much involved. I hope the entire family, you know, can find comfort, no matter how difficult it is to know that. The best tribute that he can receive, and receive the thousand a person that are here today. And that is a simple, oh, he was a joyful person, jovial person, kind person. And how we live in life. And all of us can take something from that. In ending, what have happened to Wayne is not unique to him. There's nothing else he can do now. But we who are here, at the beginning of each year, we set resolution, we reflect, we evaluate. As we go forward, let we reflect and make the necessary changes. He can't make any change anymore, but we are who are still in the land of the living. We can make changes within our life. What has happened to him is not unique, but we can examine ourselves, make the necessary changes, so that when our day comes, we can say it is well with our soul. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much, MP Phillips and Deputy Mayor Kennedy. Put your hands together for them another time. Just join us on the platform is the Assistant Pastor for the Ballymore Faith Assembly Ministry, Lay Minister Evan Smith. Put your hands together for him. He's my brother and friend. We have another tribute.
The next tribute comes to us from Omar Freight,
Deputy Executive Director of SDC. Put your hands together for him. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Other members of the officiating clergy, my colleague and friend, the Honourable Minister on the shore, who is Member of Parliament for North East Manchester. And of course, my other colleague and friend, MP Mikael Phillips, who referred to me as his opponent. I don't know if you hear of some competition, sir, but I'm not your opponent. Right now, we're here as the Deputy Executive Director of the Social Development Commission. If and when an election is called, then we can begin to think whether that opponent is my turn. But I greet you, he's my good friend. I shake his hand for a reason. I want to also shake the hand of the councillor right here. We have opposing political views, but his daughter is my daughter's best friend. They were born the same day in the same hospital. But I stand here to give a tribute in a very odd position. I am not only standing here as someone who offered myself as a political candidate who saw Nash's support. I am not only standing here as someone who is the Deputy Executive Director of a government agency, but I stand here as a personal friend, almost a brother to Nash. Many of you may not know, but two of Nash's children must say grandfather to my uncle. That makes them my cousin. And so not only am I here to support you as a leader, but I'm here to mourn with you, to celebrate with you, and to offer my own words of encouragement and condolences. But when the pastor spoke about the fact that if someone kills someone, then he must be killed by someone else, that resonated with me because I'm a firm believer in capital punishment. And as I came here and started to meet and greet my family members who are here to share with us, one of my cousins said to me, "Boy Omar, look out, be careful. Because we know that Nash was close to you. And we know that if you were there, it's possible that you could have also been killed that night." But I looked at my cousin and I said, "If I were there, though I am not God, whoever came to kill Nash would be here today being buried by Nash and Sons." And so, we are tired of those wannabes who are trying to take away our could have been. Nash could have been anything he wanted to be. He proved to you that he could be whatever he put his mind to already. He was already a successful businessman, but he could be bigger than where he was. Every time I speak to Nash, he has an idea to move into bigger things and better things. That is the Nash I know. Not only was he going to be a more successful and powerful businessman, but Nash could have become an excellent political representative. You're silent on that one. Nash loved people and people of Nash. Nash served people and people served Nash. Nash inspired people and people inspired Nash to do more for people. Nash was a consummate leader. And this is why, even though he was not a partisan, he voted for who he believes will perform and serve the people's interest. And so, when at the time I offered myself and I met with Nash, he looked me firmly in the eye and he said, "Frith, me have your opinion, but me gonna make you know. Me now just vote just because of party, me vote because of ability and performance of a candidate." That's the kind of conversation he has. And this is why, after we became closer than we were in our youth, as a leader and as a manager, I always seek to hire people and to mobilize people on my team who are as good as me or even better than I am, so that my team can do well, and if I have to move aside, someone can take over and do better than I. And in my conversation with Nash, I saw in him a leader. I saw in him someone who could become a member of parliament. Many people would have come to me and suggested to have Nash run as a councillor. Many people have offered that. And I'm going to confess to you that in recent times, he was one of the persons I started to think about very seriously. That in the same way, I have a business and I'm looking for someone who, if I can no longer run that business, that guy could do it for me. Nash was a man I thought, if I had to move out of political representation, I would have eagerly supported him to become the Member of Parliament for Northwest Manchester. And so, we don't know who killed Nash or why he was killed yet. But we know that whoever killed Nash has not killed his dreams. And if you want to kill Nash's legacy, then you're going to have to kill me, you're going to have to kill his sons. You're going to have to kill thousands of people who are here today, because all of you are legacies of Nash. And while we know there are those who walk to and fro upon this earth with weapons of mass destruction trying to kill the body, they want us to be afraid. But family members who are here, do not be afraid. Stand up for justice. But as you stand up for justice, and we want to expose the criminals, we must know the difference. Because sometimes people want to distract us. There are people who may look like criminals, but they are not criminals. Are you reading me? We must find the real killers. We are not interested in just arresting somebody who look like you could be guilty, and locking up somebody who look like them could be guilty. We want the real killers, because sometimes the real killers are sent by people who look like me and you, just bring jacket and die. So, we want to remind you, my family, as Matthew 10:28 says, "And fear not them that kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul. Rather, fear him alone that is able to destroy both the soul and the body." So anybody who thinks they want to come kill, we want to tell you, no weapons formed against us shall prosper. And we must take back Milgram, take back the place we love so much out of the hands of the criminals and the unknown who want to destroy us. And so, yes, I am extremely saddened as a friend, disturbed and perplexed at this brutal murder. Because we have a promising young businessman, a family man. Not only was Nash a could have been, but he is what you see is what you get. Not only was he my childhood friend, but someone who was supportive of our vision today. I don't know if many of you know, we started a little activity called Freestyle Friday. Why did we do it? Nash and I and other young men have been talking about the robberies in Malibali, the shootings. And sometimes you want to reach out even to the people who could very well be involved in wrongdoing. Because you want to lock up some people, but you want to reform some people too. And Nash was one of those who called me and pointed out some young people he wanted to reach out to and help to shape. And he offered his location for this event to be held. You must know that the night of his death, he and I spoke. And we were looking forward to the final of that event on December 20. And he kept telling me over and over again in his mind how he's confident, as tough as things are, he's confident that if we keep at it, we can turn the minds of some negative youth. That is what Nash lived for. He lived to make an impact, to make people better. And so, we know he provided excellent service, he created jobs for people. And as M.D. Phillips pointed out, Nash did not allow his political opinion to stop him from helping anybody. Whether you're PNP, JLP, or NOP at all, Nash was willing to provide support to you. I remember him in childhood. I always thought that Nash was a big man before he became a big man. That's the best I can remember of him. When we used to run barefooted out to Miami Community Center to play cricket, even when we were laughing at jokes, if Nash gave the joke, Nash not laugh. He just had a very serious disposition. And even now, when he's beginning to give you a piece of advice, then he says, let me tell you. And he begins to get in his mode, you know he's going to tell you something very serious and profound. And I will remember him for that continuous discipline and focus. And any businessman who speaks to you about success, there's something we call the compound effect. That is doing small things repeatedly over and over again. Discipline. and you can reap great rewards. Nash was disciplined, and he is a good example of a businessman. And so in closing, for those of us who say we grieve and mourn, let us also celebrate his life. While we await and encourage the police to do his work. Apart from the fact that the greatest victory we could have is to find the killers and bring them to justice. The greatest tribute we could pay to our friend or family or brother or our father is to live the best examples that he left for us. The best ways to immortalize him is to emanate those things about him that made you smile. Those things that gave you hope and courage to move to another day, remember them. Promise me you will remember. Unlike some men who spread their seeds all over this land and do not take care of their children, Nash was a father who stood up to his responsibility. So promise me, brothers, promise me, sons, that you are going to be a good father, just like Nash was. Promise me that the same way he was a man that lived not just for himself, but for others, he served his community. Promise me that you will remember him by serving your community as good as he did. As much as he had a temper, he was a peacemaker. So promise me, as you remember him, that you also will be a peacemaker. That is the best tribute you can give to Nash. And in closing, I wish I could sing like my friend and colleague, Minister Onishaw, but I can't sing. And so I leave these words of comfort with you, my family, friends and all. I read or I recite the song that I wish I could sing. And if you know it, you can say it after me. I say it every time I go to funeral, but this time, it touches me even deeper. One day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all I'm asking of you. Give me the strength, give the family the strength to do everything that they have to do in this time. Yesterday is gone, sweet Jesus. Nash is gone. Our brother is gone, our uncle, our friend is gone. And tomorrow may never be mine, may never be yours. But Lord, for my sake, for our sake, teach us to take one day at a time. May his soul rest in peace, and may you be comforted as you mourn. Thank you.
Vice Masters Brand will be having a musical tribute. Put your hands together for them as they come. Thank you.
This afternoon, I'm representing the Vibes Master Band. And let me tell you today, this band is Nash Band. Whenever we're going out and we have dates, Nash always tells us, do me a big uno. Uno take Femi man. And we're going out last year and we couldn't go back home because we had a motorcade and Nash said to us, uno gonna go back home. Come up a yard, you can't come, you're gonna be in. And go half for the work.
Don't remember how heartache is but a stepping stone.
Yeah!
calls me home.
Praise the offertory hymn. Tempted and tried, we have made to wonder, while it should be thus all the day long, while there are others living about us, never molested, though in the wrong. Tempted and tried, we
have made to wonder, why it should be.
Sisters, Trisha Gay Henry Wright is a relative of the deceased. Put hands together as Mrs. Henry Wright comes with the remembrance. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Remembrance for the late Wayne Anthony Nash. I still find it difficult to believe that you're really gone. It seems like only yesterday you were teaching me how to play marbles, cricket, and how to shoot a bird from a tree. Wayne Anthony Nash was born a very playful child. He was nurtured by his aunts Gloria and Olive Nash from a tender age, as his mother went to further her education. He was then sent to live with his grandmother and cousins. As a child, Wei ensured that he was always having fun, hitting us and run in order for us to catch him. But he could not outrun us, as he would burst into laughter as soon as he starts running. Wei enjoyed family time as much as he did with friends, so much so that we gave him the name Street Legal. He made sure he would finish his chores, then disappear with a friend. He also ensured that this friend would follow him home for dinner, even though he did not know if any was prepared. As time goes by, he blossomed into adolescent, remaining home with only two of his eldest cousins. Wayne now had to fend for himself, and so he made hustling a profession. While attending Malgoli High School, Wayne acquired a skill of tailoring, and my grandmother's machine was his best friend. He made sheet sets, cushions, and cushion covers and sold them. He would also make adjustments to his clothes as well as some of his friends. During his quest for what life was set out to be, Wayne, along with his cousin Terry, now Reverend Terry and Simmons, gave his life to the Lord in 1995. And was baptized at the Ballinure FAMII Church. Wayne was very devoted to this life and would not miss a church service or event. Wayne was a very determined and ambitious person. He did not know where or when he would move, but he bought a wash bath, hid it under his grandmother's bed, and filled it with items he needed to go on his own. The move took him to Kingston, where he lived with his grandmother, Mama Bai, and cousin Jackie. During his tenure in Kingston, he reunited with his common law wife, Natalie, and after a visit with her one night, Wayne and his friends were heading home when the car overturned from the Bull Bay Bridge. Wayne, thinking selflessly, quickly pulled everyone from the vehicle, ensuring that they were okay, only to find out that he was the only person to suffer from a broken neck. But God had bigger plans for him, and so he healed and came back to Manchester, operating taxi as a survival mode. Of course, we all know he had the fastest car, or so he thought. By this time, his eldest son Demario was born. Then came Jordan, Kimako, Akilia, Nashalia, Dawain, and Gawain. They were his pride, and he toiled endlessly, moving up from taxi operator to a funeral home director. Started his own business, Nash and Son's Funeral Home. And from that, he created an empire for his family. Natalie remembers Wayne one Tuesday evening while she sat with Wayne on their veranda watching the rain. The lightning began to strike, and he held her close and said, "Simone Lupe, smile, because gotta take a picture." Of course, she couldn't stop laughing. Wayne was an inspiration to all who knew him. He brought life and joy in his environment. One of his mother's fond memory of him is when she recently cooked him a meal of ackee and saltfish with yam, thinking he would enjoy it. Wayne exclaimed, "Mommy, what a dumpling there? How if you cook ackee and saltfish without dumpling?" His favorite food was haggis and dumpling, and he loved roast fish. His siblings remembered him as their mentor, as he encouraged them to have confidence in themselves and they would be successful. His staff embodies him as a cut above the rest, as they were more than just workers. To him, they were family and business partners. Wayne was a hardworking and loving role model, a perfectionist, as no business of his could be left undone. I'm sure that today he has left a permanent spot in the hearts of those who came in contact with him. Wayne, you will always be remembered as a devoted father, a wonderful brother, the perfect son, an excellent domino player, and a best friend. In all these ways, you have made our lives richer. Your life was a gift that will live on in our memories. We love you, Wayne. Rest in peace.
Thank you very much for the remembrance, Mrs. Wright. It's time for the floral tribute. Let me ask all those persons to position yourself, and the technicians will take it over.
Let my victory.
And you ain't carry strong. is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. Please don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need.
We ask God's blessing and the offering.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we give you thanks for today. We give you thanks for your loving kindness and your tender mercies. We thank you, Almighty God, for the givers today, those who had to give and those who had not. We pray, mighty God, as this offering has been designated for a purpose, that it will go for the purpose it was intended for, and that your Holy Spirit will continue to bless the givers as we give you thanks. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much. At this time, brothers and sisters, we now have a special song by Noel Benjamin. Put your hands together for Mr. Benjamin.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a sad moment, but I'm going to try to... If I get down, please just hold me up, because I met this guy a couple years ago through Janetta Humans. And because of that, you know, it's like a family. We just had a family relationship, you know, and Janetta is not here at this moment, but I'm trying to represent her and her husband and the rest of the family with this song.
I hear the sound of a mighty rushing wind, and it's closer now than it ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet. Again. I looked around me I see prophecies fulfilling and signs of the time. They're appearing everywhere.
And he says, son, go get your children. Go get your children. Oh, at the midnight ride, the bride of Christ will rise when Jesus steps out of a cloud to call his children. The dead in Christ shall rise to meet him.
Put your hands together again for everybody. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, may I ask you to stand for 30 seconds with me. Everybody, please stand. Everybody. Come on, everybody. Everybody. The Reverend Terrian Smith is a relative of the deceased. She pastors. She's a senior pastor, been having an assistant. She's a senior pastor for the Faith Assembly Ministries Church in Ballinor. She will be coming to us to bring the word. Being a member of the family is not easy for her. So I ask us all to preach with her and to bear her help in her prayers. Put your hands together. Receive the woman of God as she comes to minister. Reverend Smith, congregation, receive her.
Can we worship the Lord? Before I go any further, I'm going to pray. Glory to God. Close your eyes with me and bow your heads. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I present myself to you as a vessel of honor today. Humble enough to be used by you to these people that are here. In the name of Jesus, I come against any obstacle against your word today, the undiluted word of Almighty God. I pray for the hearers of the word today that your heart will be receptive to your word. God, I stand here today and I ask you even for one soul. That's why I'm here, God. I stand, oh God, on behalf of my family, God, in this task. Because I want even one of my family member to be saved. I pray in the name of Jesus that preaching will be easy right now. I come against every obstacle. The word of God shall go forth. Glory to God, it shall go forth unhindered in the name of Jesus. I come against every whispering spirit right now. I come against every spirit of distraction. And I declare that the heavens shall be open right now in the name of Jesus. And every blockage shall be removed. I command you to be moved in the name of Jesus. And allow the blessings which is to come down as the praises go up to come down unhindered. In Jesus' mighty name, I go forth as in authority granted unto me as a servant of God to preach his word. It shall be unhindered. No weapon formed. Let every tongue in this place be bright. In the name of Jesus, any spirit that is not of God, I subdue you now. And your time has come to an end. You shall reign no more. be silent. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. You may be seated. A pleasant afternoon, family, friends, and loved ones. Let me pause to acknowledge each and every one, and due to time's sake, glory to God, I will not single you out by name. So I acknowledge at this time our able moderator, other members of the clergy sitting on the platform, political representatives that are here. Glory to God, and may I say additional based on what he said, Mr. Omar Fritz, the only person I'll single out. Families, friends, loved ones, just about everyone that is here this afternoon, Jesus loves you. Glory to God. Can we praise the Lord? Can we give the Lord a bigger praise? You know why I ask you to praise the Lord? This is the day that the Lord has made. And if somebody would just rejoice with me now and be glad in it, just jump to your feet and lift up the name of Jesus. You know why I ask you to do that? Because we are not defeated, glory to God. The devil thought that he had us, but little did the devil know, glory to God, this is to strengthen us. We are coming out of this stronger than we entered in, and if you believe, just worship the Lord. Whether you are a Christian, yes or no, lift your hands and shout, hallelujah, glory to God. You know why I stand here and stand strong? Yes, I am strong, glory to God. Because the Lord is my strength. As you heard, I was baptized with Wayne in 1995. We grew up together. So, why am I not crying? Why am I not mourning? Because I have a God who is bigger than this. He's my sustainer and my keeper. Glory to God. So much of me. Let me turn to the remainder of families and loved ones who are mourning today. And I hope that I'll be able to bring you a word of comfort. Glory to God. It's not common for you to ask why. And throughout all of this, since November 30th, I've been hearing a lot of whys. Even I myself have been asking, why could we have lost Wayne like this? Glory to God. He was an outgoing, full of life, loving, understanding, very focused, set goals for himself. And wasn't satisfied until all his goals were achieved. He was such a good father. He was such a good son, brother, uncle, cousin, employer, friend, godfather, and you name it. Many questions and few answers. We're heartsick, aren't you? We have heard it from beginning until now. We are heartsick, we're broken hearted. Not only about his death, but the many other deaths. Glory to God. Well, let me tell you today that God himself is sick. God is sick. The scripture says that God hates death and he loves us. Glory to God. That means death is an enemy. So it's an enemy that caused us to be here. So we dare not blame God. He too is sick and he too hates death. Someone wonder then, why didn't God do something about it? Because the time has not yet come. Death as an enemy must reign until God put all enemies under his feet. And the word of God continues to say, death is the last enemy that will be destroyed. So that's why he said, leave vengeance unto him. The mandate that caused us to be here and is mourning today, he himself shall be put to death. Can you worship the Lord? Give the Lord a bigger praise. Because the enemy shall be defeated. It's just a matter of time before this enemy is put down. Just clap your hands for the Lord this afternoon. In the meantime, I do hope I brought some comfort to you by saying this enemy, glory to God. Because there's a popular singer that you may murder the murderer, but you cannot murder the spirit of murder. The spirit continues to reign, and it is that's why the spirit of death himself will be put to death. Can we worship the Lord? Go down and hunt the murderer and murder him, but the spirit moves on. Glory to God. And as such, today I encourage you and invite you just to wrap your hands, if they're long enough, around yourself. Glory to God. And I'm going to ask God to comfort you now. We're going to sing the song, Jesus Loves Me, This I Know. You may say that's a child song, but Jesus said, except we are like children in our ways, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So let the children of God this afternoon wrap your hands around yourself. And we're going to sing, Jesus loves me, this I know. Come on, let us sing. Let Jesus comfort you. Go ahead and wrap your hands. Don't be afraid. Maybe you have not received here. Glory to God.
Jesus loves me.
Jesus. He's your comforter and your sustainer, and it is He, if you allow Him, who is going to carry you through until the end of this age. Glory to God. Worship the Lord. So now that I have tried my best with the help of God to comfort you, let me move on into the Word of God, because this Word is not for Wayne, because he cannot help Wayne. Glory to God. This Word is for us who remains here today. Can we worship the Lord? Glory to God. And so, glory to God, we are tired. I asked you earlier, and I know you're tired. It's a rhetorical question. Are you tired of the present situation? The crime, the violence, the heartache, the headache, the suffering, the pain that is upon mankind. Are you tired? Let me tell you today, God has an action plan. Glory to God. Revelation 21:4. Glory to God. You may write it down, or if you want to turn to it. And this is what part of the plan is, an assurance. And it says, and God shall wipe away every tear from their eyes. Are you crying today? God shall wipe away your tears at some point. Glory to God. And he goes on to say, there shall be no more death. There shall be no more coughing. Glory to God. There shall be no more funeral ceremony. There shall be no more like this at the time that will come. This is God's action plan. And it goes on to say, there shall be no more pain. There's some of you here today, glory to God, you're suffering emotionally, glory to God. And as a result of the emotional pain, so it has turned into physical pain. But God says there's a time that is coming when it shall be no more. And he continues to say, the form of things have passed. I'm talking about what is to come, glory to God. Are you anticipating what is to come? Glory to God, are you anticipating what is to come? And as a result of what God says here, I stand to tell you that the former and the present things, the past things, shall pass away. This shall be no more. At some point in life, as you heard the song sung earlier, when Jesus steps out, there are so many, as I say this, he's saying, when will this be? But it shall be when Jesus steps out, glory to God. For whether we've embraced it, yes or no, there is coming a time when the cloud shall be open, and the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, he will step out to call his children home. And that's why I'm speaking to you here today, that you need Jesus before that time come, glory to God. Because Jesus is coming back. Is that amen? Do you believe he's coming back? This wasn't a part of his plan. Everything that you see going on is not his plan. God loves man, and he created man in his likeness and his image as worshipers to reign with him, glory to God. But something happened a long time ago and keeps happening. And Jesus is going to put an end to it and redeem, glory to God. Do you want to be redeemed? Just seek the Lord while he may be found. Can we worship the Lord? Can we worship the Lord, glory to God? As I said to you, the former things shall pass away. When Jesus stepped out, Revelation 22:7 says, and behold, I come quickly. Glory to God. Jesus is coming quickly. Can we worship the Lord? 2 Timothy 2, 1 to 5, 3, 1 to 5. Glory to God. We may be wondering when, but the time is near. It says, but understand this concerning his coming, that in the last days there will come times of great difficulty. Aren't we experiencing difficulties? Am I the only one, or are we experiencing difficulties? I'm talking about the end which is coming, glory to God. And the scripture goes on to say, for people will become lovers of themselves. Haven't you seen it around? Glory to God. And it goes on to say, lovers of money, glory to God. The love of money is a root of all evil. A man will kill you for a dollar, glory to God. Can we worship the name of Jesus? And the scripture goes on to say, people will become proud and arrogant. Have we seen enough pride and arrogance around us? It said people will become abusive. We have seen enough. People become disobedient to parents. In this age, you're hearing of children slaughtering their parents. We are talking about Jesus coming. He's about to step out. Can we worship the Lord? And it goes on to say people become ungrateful, unholy, heartless. Glory to God. Talking about heartless. It is why Wayne was killed, because the heart of men have been waxed cold. Glory to God. No feeling, no emotion, no compassion. And it says, without self-control, men will become brutal, not loving good, reckless, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. I just tell you earlier, the signs of the time, aren't we experiencing these signs? If we're experiencing, say amen, glory to God. Will you agree with me today that we're experiencing the signs of the time? And because we're experiencing the signs of the time, it is enough to say that Jesus is about to step out. Matthew 26:24-6. And you will hear of wars and rumors of war. Glory to God. Let us pray for America and Iran, for those who are up in current affairs. There shall be wars and rumors of war. We're talking about the end to come. Glory to God. Matthew 24:36. Glory to God. Because there are some women, man, boy, and girl who says, I'm not ready to serve God. I have to live up a little longer. Glory to God. Because when Jesus is coming, I can do this. But this is what the Bible says concerning his coming. Glory to God. It says, and glory to God. And because, and but concerning that day, no one knows the hour. None of us will know the hour. God bless those like the thief on the cross who had an opportunity to say, Lord, forgive me. Remember me when you get into your kingdom. So that's why I'm saying to you today, seek the Lord while he may be found. Can we worship the Lord? Can we worship the Lord? He says, not even angels in heaven nor the Son, but the Father only that knows when Jesus shall step out. All we know is that he shall and he will step out anytime now, because all these signs which he have given to us, they are happening, have been happening and still happening. So at any given time, the Lord shall step out. Can we worship the Lord? And because Jesus is going to come back and he's coming in soon, glory to God, what are we going to do about it? Glory to God. We must live. This is what I apply today and encourage you to apply. Live in the context of eternity. What do I mean by living in the context of eternity? Take a stock of our lives. Understand that we're not here to stay. Embrace the fact that there is coming a day when everything shall change. As he said, the former things shall pass away, glory to God. That means we're going to live a way that when this change comes, we're going to live a way that when Jesus steps out, we will be a part of his children that he will call home. We will be one of them that will be caught up. We will be one of them that will be changed in the twinkling of an eye. We will be a part today. Where is your heart? Where is your heart? living in the context of eternity. Make sure that the life we live today directs us into eternity with Jesus Christ. Because there'll be eternity with God, and there'll be eternity in the everlasting lake of fire. There are those who say God loves us too much to burn people up. But let me tell you today that hell was not made for man, glory to God. But God, the God he is, he gives man an opportunity to choose. But today I encourage you, choose Christ, choose life, choose right, glory to God. That is the straight and narrow way. Glory to God. Some people, when you say seek God, they wonder, I can't do it, but it's not by self. It's not by might, but it's by the Spirit of the living God. It's God that leads, and where he leads, you follow. Is there someone today that is willing to follow the leading of Jesus Christ? Because I know without a doubt right now, glory to God, that the Holy Spirit is speaking to the heart, the convictor of souls. He's right here talking to somebody. He says, behold, I stand at your door and knock. And if any man hear, and you would open the door, is there one today that will open the door? That little jittering in your knee that you're feeling, that's the Holy Spirit right now. Don't turn him away this afternoon, because no man knows the day nor the hour. Can we worship the Lord? Can we worship the Lord? Glory to God. And so Psalm, speaking about living in the context of eternity, I bring to you Psalm 90:12, and it says, as a result of the fact that we're not here to stay, then teach, glory to God, it says, teach me to number my days, glory to God. Why? That I may apply my heart unto wisdom. What wisdom? That as I said before, I am not here to stay. This world is not my home. I am just passing through. This is pilgrimage, glory to God. So gain all you want to gain. Earn all you want to earn. But there's coming a day, glory to God. Naked we come and naked we shall return. When the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords shall require of us our soul, the breath of life which he blew into man on that day when he said, come let us make man. Your soul is worth more than your body. Our soul's worth more than our hairdo. Our soul's worth more than the vehicle we drive. Our soul's worth more than our titles, glory to God. Take care of your souls. Give your life to Jesus. Give your life to Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Speaking of that, let me just give you a little, it's not a story, and it's not just good read, and it's in closing, glory to God. As the Holy Spirit continues to knock, the Bible spoke of a man, glory to God, a rich man and a poor man, Lazarus, glory to God. And the rich man was living up, glory to God. And the poor man was a beggar, glory to God, but the poor man knew God. And so the rich man died, and the poor man, glory to God, was carried up, glory to God, ushered. And so the rich man, glory to God, the Bible says the rich man called out from hell, glory to God. And the rich man called out to Abraham and said, Father Abraham, can you just send Lazarus? I'm just here to tell you that hell is real. The Bible speaks of somebody who has gone there and come back and tell us, glory to God, that hell is real. He said, can you send Lazarus just to tip his finger in some water because hell is hot? Glory to God. I almost said a church, but let me go ahead anyhow. Church, hell is hot. Hell is not made for man, glory to God. Hell is made for the devil and his angels. You don't want to make it to hell. I don't want to go to hell. This is why I choose Jesus Christ. It's not easy road. It's not an easy road. Those who have walked with him, as you heard, Nash was baptized in 1995. Unfortunately, glory to God. I won't touch that. God knows. Glory to God. It's not an easy walk, but glory to God. He tells us that the crown of glory that awaits us, glory to God, far exceeds that which we will experience when we walk with him. And he says, if you suffer with him, you will reign with him. Is there one this afternoon in closing that wishes and wants to reign with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords when he steps out? Is there one today who want to say, what that day of that first resurrection, I want to be one of them who will be risen. I want to be one of them who will be caught up to meet him in the sky. Choose Christ today, glory to God. Be ready for the passing away. I told you earlier that there is going to be a passing away of the former things. Be ready for the passing away. Glory to God. In closing, yes, I'm closing. Is there one today that wants to start the process of being ready for this passing away? Glory to God, where God says, oh death, this is a day when death will have no hold on your body. Oh death, where is thy sting? Glory to God. Oh death, where is your victory? Glory to God. We have victory. Those who accept Christ and those who will accept Christ today, you have victory through Jesus Christ. Because he himself was once touched by this enemy, but he had to walk that road for you and for me. Jesus died so that we can live. Glory to God. Is there one who wants to live? This is not life that we're living. The life to live is that which is to come. Is there one? Is there one? Is there one today? Is there one who will seek the Lord while he may be found? Is there a family member, a worker, a friend that will put your hands up, stick your hands in the air? You know what? He says, if you're afraid to own me among people, I will not own you when I come. Is there one in here today? What I'm doing is giving you an opportunity, glory to God. Because every man, woman, and boy and girl shall give account. On that day, you cannot say your cousin, your daughter, your sister did not tell you, did not encourage you to serve God. You're going to answer to God. Is there one? Is there one, family members? Is there one of you today who will help me to pray? Is there one? Is there one who will help me to pray for the family? Is there one, because people are going to die? Yes. Is there one? Is there one that will follow in the steps? Glory to God. I'm about to hand over the mic. Is there one? Glory to God, as a watchman ordained by Jesus Christ. Your blood would be required upon me, my hands, if I don't tell you. And this is why today, before I take my seat, passing and after his passing, Jesus will step out. And there is going to be an eternity. Either eternity with the Lord Jesus Christ, or eternity into the lake of fire that the rich man experienced and called out to Father Abraham and said, Tell Lazarus to dip his finger in a little bit of water. And I believe, glory to God, that he had sent out a message to his family. Family members, loved ones, friends, hell is real. You want to escape hell? For the very last time. For the very last time, and this is not just for families. Let not his death go in vain. Is there one? Is there one who want to recommit to the Lord? Is there a friend that wants to choose Jesus? I did say that's the last call. I did say that's the last call. It's either yes, I choose Jesus, or no, I don't want Jesus. That's the reality. Glory to God. Bow your heads and close your eyes. Heavenly Father God, I thank you for your words of comfort. I thank you for your words of challenge today to this crowd, this congregation, mourners. Your word that told us that you're returning at some point. Your words that tell us on that day there will be a separation, eternal damnation, or eternity with you. You said in your word, oh God, that you are gone to prepare a place for us. Because this world is not our home. We're just passing through. Thank you for telling us today that we are just living for a short time. Oh God, your word said the number of the days of men are 70. And by reason of strength, we would continue. Mighty God, we thank thank you today that everyone under the hearing of my voice had an opportunity and still have an opportunity to turn their life over if they have not yet done so. Father, I thank you that I've delivered as you have laid upon my heart. I thank you today for your blessings and for the remainder of this program. In Jesus' name, glory to God. Give the Lord a clap of praise. Glory to God. Glory to God. Before I take my seat, let me boldly say glory to God. Family members, we know we love each other because that's the legacy of our grandmother. She taught us how to love. But God knows sometimes we don't show it the way we should. Yes, other people are hearing truth is truth and God loves truth. So I'm going to ask, if you're here and your heart is not right with another family member, that you'll make peace. Make peace. Know God, K-N-O-W God, and you will know peace. And if you don't know God, that's N-O God, then there is no peace. The right thing to do, nobody knew that Nash would have passed. It came as a surprise. We don't know when another will, because as I say, death is an enemy. Bear with me, other person, let me speak to my family. Make peace. Tell somebody, let's go off some things and embrace God. God bless your heart. I know that may never go down well, but God would have charged me if I didn't speak the truth and speak what he wants. God bless you. Thank you for hearing me out. At this point, glory to God. At this point, before I turn over, I'm going to give some directives for the remainder, glory to God. We're not yet through, and I do hope that you'll just hold on for the end. But there will be two repasses for those who won't make it to Ballinure, where the internment will be. A repass will be in Mangoli Square, yes, and the other will be in Ballinure. All right, the police officers, they're asking that we travel one route. So we don't want some going east and some going west. They're here on spot and they'll be giving directives. So please follow. We want to ensure there is safety on the roads. You have done very well today. Glory to God. Bless God. I now hand over back to our able moderator.
Thank you very much, Reverend Henry. Put your hands together again for her. To God be the glory. The words have gone forth. And the Bible said, he who have an ear to hear, let him hear. The eulogy will come to us by Paulette Forbes, cousin of the deceased, and Trisha Hayes, sister of the deceased. Put your hands together as they come.
Good afternoon, everyone. There's so much to say about Wayne. He was such a special guy. But I will start. Natalie and the children, his parents, Michael and Lorna, his two other mothers, Aunt G and Aunt Olive, his sisters, brothers, aunts, uncles, cousins, employees, the clergy, our political representation, and all who sits in the podium, friends, supporters, and the community at large. We're here to celebrate the life of Wayne and Tony Nash. And this truly has been a celebration. Sometime in the month of February 1980, a seed was sown for what would become an amazing young man. It was on November 6, 1980, that this little kernel popped into the world. He came from very humble beginnings, but he came from good soil. As a result, goodness took root, as is evidenced by the support that we have today. I will share a little family secret. The Ballinger Malgali part of the Nash family is dominated by strong women. His father was one of two brothers who had nine sisters. So when a male came into the family with the name Nash, it was like royalty. A new prince was born. And it was more than having a new baby. Wayne was no exception. After all those many years, without a new Nash prince, Wayne was welcomed as the eldest child of Uncle Mikey. And subconsciously, I think we have elevated him to king. It was within this vein that Lorna, as a young mother, found arms outstretched to help her raise her son so that she could pursue a better life than she had envisioned. Wayne's aunt Olive and Gloria were too happy to stand in as mothers, while the rest of the family showered him with love and support that children need in order to grow into well-adjusted adults. Parents, aunts, uncles, cousins, we ask you, shower and guide and support the young children with the love that they need to be strong adults. Because Wayne is a true testimony of what love, the strength of love, can be. Wayne moved to Malgali when he was only a few months old. He grew up in a family of small business owners. Aunt Olive, a restaurateur, and Aunt G owned a bar and grocery. Who knew that was the path of entrepreneurism was charted at this early age for Wayne? He knew the patrons of his aunt's businesses. The story is told that as a young boy, he knew one of the local patrons what he would order when he came into the bar. So whenever he saw the gentleman, he would say, "One rum," because that's all the man would order. When Wayne was in Magdalene, he could always be seen in his aunt's businesses. I am sure he was sharpening his business acumen. That's why he became such a successful businessman. In fact, there are times when he would be sent to the private residence in the back. But within minutes, he would make his way back to the business. That infectious smile and warmth that he exuded made one overlook or even forgot that he was just sent to the private quarters. Now we understand this child's curiosity was laying the foundation for what would result in one of the most beautiful, successful role models in our family. As he transitioned from childhood to adulthood, Wayne exhibited a clarity of purpose that was so mature. He was never complacent. He was a kind man. He was a compassionate man. He was non-judgmental. He was empathetic. He looked out for those who were less fortunate, as evidenced by the collection today to make a home for someone who it does not have it. Wayne was a noble man. He was an honorable man. He encouraged and he empowered those with whom he came in contact. Wayne was an excellent partner and a father. His family was his first priority. Natalie and children We will miss Wayne, but I know you will miss him more. Wayne was so many things to so many people, as you all heard today. This seed, planted in good soil, took root. Although he has harvested all the crops that he could, the roots of love, compassion, empathy, forgiveness, and hope will sustain us. Ladies and gentlemen, let us use this occasion to commit ourselves to continuing Wayne's work of love, empowerment, and hope. This is how we will honor him as he takes flight into eternity. His sister Trisha will share some of the memories that made him such a special person in our family, our community, and I would say to Jamaica as a whole. Jamaica has lost a hero.
Wagwan, the sister, this was my brother's greeting whenever we would see each other. I'm Trisha, and Wayne is my big brother. A brother I am proud to have. He was dependable, and as everyone said before, compassionate, affectionate, friendly, and direct. The kind of person who would go out of his way to help family, friends, and persons who he would meet for the very first time. 1 Corinthians 13 verse 11 says that when I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. And when I became a man, I put aside childish things. At an early age, Wayne had embraced the responsibility of a man. At age 17, he got involved in sales. And then at age 18, his entrepreneurial mindset led to his first business venture, having a taxi operation from Ballinor to Malgully, which he did for 3 years. He later went to live in Kingston and began obtaining experience working in construction and a supermarket. After the motor vehicle accident where he broke his neck at age 21, he then returned to his birth parish, Manchester, where he began to operate a taxi again, running from Malgully to Mandeville. His taxi operation was doing well, but wanted to challenge himself even more because he believed in development and growth. While operating his taxi, he was also working for Coley and Son's funeral home. He found a new passion for the field and subsequently opened his own funeral parlor, and yes, the name is Nash and Sons, and sold his car, that's the taxi, to purchase the first set of caskets for his showroom. As a startup business owner, he rented hearses until he himself could later acquire two of his own. He also owned a car wash and provided capital investments to begin a clothing store. His business also helped to support local charities, like what was said before, sponsoring back to school treats and Christmas trees for the children in different communities, distributing the supplies himself to children. Natalie and Wayne began a family welcoming his firstborn son and subsequently another 6 to the Nash legacy. His pride and joy was his entire family, but especially his children, Nashan, Jordan, Kimako, Akilia, Nashalia, Gawain, and Dwayne. He was a hands-on father, a provider, helping with the care of the children, giving guidance. He was playful, but was also a disciplinarian when needed. His passion and drive was to see his family thrive and be happy. And we can all attest to that, right? When you're around him, how he wanted to make you feel happy. And to his children, he was proud of you and having you as his kids. He loved you each very dearly. May his legacy as a success-driven individual, philanthropist, and a leader in his community continue to live through you and all of us.
His love for his parents and adopted parents, Mikey, Lorna, Aunt Olive, Aunt G, and Granny, was present and known throughout. We, as family and friends, near and far, after interacting with him, saw an example of how we can be better humans with more love for self and for others. Speaking of love, his love for sports. So last year was World Cup, right? So for those who knew him, you knew who he was cheering for. What team was that? Brazil. Brazil to the world, as he would say. He watched football with his brothers, sons, and friends. He would watch anywhere he could. Another sport that he loved was cricket. He not only watched the sport, but he played it as well. He found ways to contribute to the development of the sport in the community through his business, Nash & Sons, and did so by sponsoring trophies, competitions in the community. Lastly, if he was on a break from attending one of his businesses, he would be at a domino table competition with friends for gifts of their choice. If dominoes are in heaven, he is having a tournament with his new friends right now. A limb has fallen. A limb has fallen from the family tree. I keep hearing a voice that says, "Grieve not for me." Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I've lived while I was strong. Continue my heritage, she would say. I am counting on you. Keep smiling, and surely the sun will shine through. My mind is at ease. My soul is at rest, remembering all how truly I was blessed. Continue traditions, no matter how small. Go on with life, don't worry about falls. I miss you dearly, so keep up your chin until the day comes we're together again. Rest in peace, Wayne.
That was final item, or sorry, put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them. Let me ask everybody to stand. Let me ask the undertaker to take your position. This is how we leave here, straight to the
eternity. Then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Perfectly, but when you to more than I can be. the sun, where to stand in the morning, and who told the ocean you can only come this far, and who showed the moon where to hide till evening.
Overcome. Praise the Lord, Auntie.
All right. No.
We at first.
Sing. And the lady cries out, run, no greater than
mine. No greater than hold my body down. And when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise, no grave can hold my body down.
Praise the Lord.
Other persons with the lady, can you do so now for me? Thank you.
Sleep on, beloved. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you, but Jesus loves you best. Good night. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you, but Jesus loves you best. Good night.